वेलकम व्यूअर्स, यू आर वाचिंग द वीडियो लेक्चरर क्लास UN ऑटोनॉमस कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. आई एम प्रतीचि दास, लेक्चरर इन MCOM F&C. सो इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज फॉरेन एक्सचेंज, व्हाट आर द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज और फॉरेन हाउ द फॉरेन एक्सचेंज इज डिटर्मिंड, व्हाट आर द रीजंस फॉर फ्लक्चुएशंस ऑफ फॉरेन करेंसी, what are the forces for demand and supply of foreign currency, and what are the types of currency exchange rate system. So today we will discuss about what is foreign exchange market. So what is foreign exchange market? So market is a place where goods and services are traded. So let's start about the foreign exchange market. So let's start. What is foreign exchange market? The market where the commodity traded is currencies, and the price of each currency is determined in terms of other currency. So as we know, market is a place where goods and services are traded or commodities are traded. Foreign exchange market is a market, or it is a marketplace where the commodity is traded, that is known as our currency. Every country have different types of currencies, or every countries are using currencies for exchanging of goods and services like rupees, US dollar, pound, yen, etc. So the foreign exchange market is a place where the commodity is traded, that is known as our currency, and that currency is determined with the value of another country's currency or with the process of another country's currency, and that determination value is known as our exchange rate. So foreign exchange market is a place of trading different types of foreign currency, which is determined with the value of another currency or another country's currency. So there are different functions of foreign exchange market. The foreign exchange market serves two main functions. One is to convert the currency of one country into the currency of another, and another one is to provide some insurance against foreign exchange risk. So the foreign exchange market has different types of functions are there, and foreign exchange market plays different types of functions. The first function of a foreign exchange market is to convert the currency of one country into the other country's currency. That means the currency of a one country is converted or fixed or determined with the currency of another country. So if we take an example, the Indian rupee will be determined, or Indian rupee will be exchanged with some value, and that should be determined with some value, that is US dollar, and that US dollar should be exchanged or determined with the value of the pound, and that is known as our fixing or exchanging or determining the currency of one country with the another country. And the another function of the foreign exchange market is to give some insurance or provide some insurance facility against the risk. That means the risk will be arise when the currencies are converted or when the currencies are exchanged, one country's currency with the another country's currency. So that risk may be risk is known as our fluctuations of currency, and that risk can be maintained with the providing of different types of facilities, that is known as our hedging facility, and that facility is provided by the foreign exchange market. So foreign exchange market has two types of function. One is converting the currency with the another country's currency and providing the insurance facilities for fluctuation or at the time of risk in an anticipated situation. Here we will discuss about what is foreign exchange transaction. So Any financial transaction that involves more than one currency is a foreign exchange transaction. And the most important characteristics of a foreign exchange transaction is that it involves foreign exchange risk. Any financial transaction with the related to the currency or with related to the exchange rate, that is known as our foreign currency transaction. That means the transaction means exchanging of goods and services with paying some amount of value or with some value. And when a country import or exports or country exchanges some goods and services, a country has to pay with the value of that country's currency, or that is determined by one country's currency with the another country's currency. And that financial transaction, may be in the form of currency, and that is known as our foreign exchange transaction. The most important characteristics of foreign exchange transaction is that it involves foreign exchange risk. So, foreign exchange transaction also involves with different types of foreign exchange risks, and that risk should be decided, and that risk should be arises due to as the currencies are determined or as the currencies are exchanged with the another country's currency, or one country's currency is exchanged or determined with the another country's currency. Therefore, there must be the chances of fluctuation of currency, or currencies may be appreciated or depreciated, and that is there is the reason of or the chances of arising of different types of risk due to the financial transaction or foreign exchange transaction. So different participants are there in the foreign exchange market. The different participants are Reserve Bank of India or Central Bank of the country, the multinational companies, broker, resident Indians or non-residents or individuals, and all commercial banks. So, there are different players or different participants in the foreign exchange market who are playing important role in the foreign exchange market. As foreign exchange market is a marketplace of exchanging or determining one country's currency with the another country's currency, there are different players in the market. They are every country's central bank, and the India has the central bank is Reserve Bank of India, the multinational companies and different brokers, all commercial banks, individuals, corporates, etc. So, first we go to the Central Bank or Reserve Bank of India. The Reserve Bank of India or Central Bank of every country plays an important role in the foreign exchange market. They are playing the role of determining the exchange rate in a fixed exchange rate system or according to the demand and supply of the foreign currency. What is the requirement of foreign currency in a country? The central bank of every country plays an important role, and they are playing an important participating role in every country for determining the exchange rate. So, the central bank is an important bank, or central bank is a participant in a foreign exchange market who decided or determined different types of exchange rate, what is the requirement of a country, for what amount of foreign currency is required for a country, what is the balancing position of the country, or what is the equilibrium or disequilibrium position of exchange rate of a country, what should be needed to take different types of measures for maintaining equilibrium or maintaining the appreciation of the foreign currency and domestic currency, appreciation of domestic currency to maintaining the balance between the foreign currency and the domestic currency, what measures to be taken for maintaining the domestic currency's devaluation. So, the Reserve Bank of India plays an important role in the foreign exchange market. So, another participants in the foreign exchange market is multinational companies or different corporates or different companies. Multinational companies are the major non-bank participants in the foreign exchange market. The multinational companies often contract to either pay or receive fixed amount in foreign currencies in future dates. So, they are exposed to foreign currency risk. This is why they often hedge this future cash flow through the different types of interbank forward exchange market. The multinational companies are the important player in the foreign exchange market, as they are playing the role in the foreign exchange market, or they are involved with the foreign exchange market for exchanging of goods and services. And in a foreign exchange market, there must be the chances of risk or fluctuations of the currency. And there is the chances of risk, the MNCs or multinational companies or different types of corporates are use the foreign exchanges for exchanging their goods, use the foreign exchanges for transacting in a foreign market. So, as the foreign currencies or as the exchange rates are going to be fluctuate in future, they want to minimize that fluctuation, or they want to lock that particular fluctuations of foreign currency in a future date. So, they lock that particular currency with different types of hedging instruments that are future contract, forward contract, options and swap. They are using different types of hedging or derivative instruments, and they lock the price for future fluctuations of the exchange rate, and they are the important participants in a foreign exchange market. Another participants in the foreign exchange market are broker. Foreign exchange brokers also operate in international currency market, and they act as agents who facilitate trading between dealers. Unlike the banks, brokers serve merely as matchmakers and do not put their own money at risk. And they actively and constantly monitor exchange rates offered by the major international banks through different computerized systems. So, brokers are the participants in the foreign exchange market. The brokers are the intermediary between the buyer and seller. They directly do not transacted in a foreign exchange market. They transacted and they meet the buyer and seller or importer and exporter in the foreign exchange market, and they impose a rate for that particular transaction between the importer and exporter, and that is known as our brokerage rate. So, they are the broker, or the broker are the important player in the foreign exchange market, who meet the importer and exporter and determine how the exchange rate will be fluctuate in future, and they protect the importer and exporter from the fluctuations of the foreign currency. So, they are playing an important role in the foreign exchange market. The another participants in the foreign exchange market is resident Indians and non-resident Indians, or individuals or small business houses, who are playing an important role in the foreign exchange market, as they are transacting or they make a transaction between different countries with the help of foreign exchange transaction, and they have the chances of to face the fluctuations of exchange rate, and they are playing the role for themselves, or they are transacting the foreign currencies for their own requirement, and they are also the important player in the foreign exchange market, because they are using the foreign currency, and the foreign currency appreciation or foreign currency depreciation or any fluctuations arises in the foreign exchange market will affect the individuals, the residents, the non-residents and the small business houses. The another participants of the foreign exchange market is the commercial bank. So the commercial banks are playing important role in the foreign exchange market, as they are playing the role of exchanging different goods and services and paying and receipt of different foreign currencies and converting the domestic currency into foreign currency and converting the foreign currency into domestic currency. So they are playing an important role in the foreign exchange market, and they are the important participants in the foreign exchange market. The functions of foreign exchange market are three types. One is transfer function, another one is the credit function, and third one is hedging function. So what is transfer function? The transfer function is the basic and the most visible function of foreign exchange market in the transfer of funds from one country to another for the settlement of payments. It is basically includes the conversion of one currency to another, where the role of forex is to transfer the purchasing power from one country to another country. So the foreign exchange market has three types of functions. One is transfer function, another one is the credit function, and third one is the hedging function. So in the case of transfer function, the transfer function plays an important role through the conversion of one country's currency into the another currency. So the transfer function focuses particularly the conversion of one currency with the another currency. As every country is involved with the exchanges of goods and services or import and export of goods and services, so they have to pay or they have to receive in different types of currencies. So they require different types of foreign currencies with the country to which they are deal with. So it is necessary to convert one currency to the another currency, and that important function or that function and that facility is provided by the foreign exchange market for conversing of one currency with the another currency, and that is known as forex facilitate. Different types of conversing facility of country's currency with the another currency for the payment and settlement of different types of transactions. The another function of foreign exchange market is credit function. That is, the forex provides a certain credit to the importer so as to facilitate the smooth flow of goods and services from one country to another country, and importer can use credit to finance the foreign purchase. So every country does not have the sufficient amount of foreign currencies with whom they are deal with. So the forex or foreign exchange market and the market participants are providing different types of credit facilities to the importers and exporters who are the player in the foreign exchange market, and they are transacting the goods and services and different types of financial transactions. So the foreign exchange market or forex facilitates different types of credit facilities to the importer for the purpose of paying that particular purchase in a foreign country, and that is known as our credit functions of foreign exchange market. The another function of foreign exchange market is hedging function, and this is the last functions of foreign exchange market. It is the function to hedge foreign exchange risks. The parties to the foreign exchange are often afraid of the fluctuations in the exchange rate, that is, the price of one currency in terms of another. The change in the exchange rate may result in a gain or loss to the party concerned. So another function of foreign exchange market is hedging function. So hedging means minimization of risk. In a foreign exchange market, there is the chances of risk, or foreign exchange market is involved with the risk. The risk is that there is the chances of fluctuations of currency at the time of conversion of one currency into the another. So that type of risk or that fluctuating moment can be minimized with the process of having the hedging process or with the process of hedging. So hedging is a process of minimizing the risk transactions involved in a foreign currency transaction. The foreign currencies are appreciated and depreciated, and foreign currencies are fluctuated according to the economical condition or according to the market condition. Therefore, the hedging facilities are provided by the foreign exchange market or forex to keep the players who are playing the important role in the foreign exchange market to protect them, which types of risks are arises in the foreign exchange market. So here we have already discussed about different types of foreign exchange functions, that are transfer functions, credit functions and hedging functions. Then we will discuss about the foreign exchange market. So the foreign exchange market is basically two types. One is spot market, another one is the forward market. So the spot market refers to the market in which the receipts and payments are made immediately. In trading on forex market, spot refers to the price of the currency at the time you see in on the trading platform, and it can be visualized like price at the spot, which is called also as the cash market. So the foreign exchange market are basically two types. One is spot market, another one is the forward market. So spot market is the market where the price of that particular transaction is settled on that particular time, and that on that particular date, what is the price on the screen or trading screen, that is known as our spot market or spot exchange rate. So in the spot market, all receipts and payments are made immediately, and the price at the spot is visualized in the trading platform, and it is also called as the cash market. So in the spot market, all receipts and payments are made immediately. That means in that particular spot, it should be decided what is the actual price of that particular currency and how the currency is converted with the another currency in that particular rate, and the payment and receipt should be made immediately, and the spot price is shown on the trading platform, and the spot market is otherwise known as our cash market because the receipts and payments are made immediately. The settlement for spot market takes 2 days for most currencies. That is, settlement means that currencies change their owner. The 2 days is referred to brokers and financial institutions and not for small individuals who trade over broker. So in the spot market, there must be the settlement process. The settlement happens immediately for the individuals, for the small businesses houses immediately on that particular spot, and that is known as our settlement of spot market. But for the brokers or different types of institutions, they have the 2 days trading facilities, and their settlement happens after 2 days, and that is known as our spot market. So in the spot market, that is the payment and received immediately. That means when buyer paid to the seller, the immediate delivery of the goods and services are delivered by the seller immediately to the buyer. So spot market is known as our cash market, and immediate payment and receipt should be happen in the spot market. So another one or another type of foreign exchange market is forward market, which refers to the market in which sale and purchase of foreign currency is settled on a specified future date agreed upon today. Currency forwards are OTC contracts or over the counter contracts traded in forex market that lock in an exchange rate for a currency pair, and they are generally used for hedging and can have customized terms such as particular national amount or delivery period. So the next market of foreign exchange market is forward market. In the forward market, there are also buyer and seller of foreign currencies are there. So So forward market is a place for hedging or minimizing the foreign currency fluctuations risk. So in this market, the buyer and seller lock the particular future price or future fluctuations of currency price in a spot rate or spot date immediately. So if they speculate or if they imagine the currency will be fluctuate or currency will be appreciate or depreciate in future market or in a future, then they lock that particular price on a spot rate for future transaction, and that is known as our forward market. So forward market is a market where the transactions are happened with the over the counter market, and it is a hedging process, hedging of or minimizing the fluctuations of currency risks. So these are known as our two types of foreign exchange market, that is spot market and forward market. Here we totally discussed about the foreign exchange market. In a foreign exchange market, we overall totally discussed that is what is foreign exchange rate and foreign exchange market, how the foreign currency or foreign exchange are determined in the foreign exchange market, different types of foreign exchange rate, the participants in the foreign exchange market, and what are the demand and supply of the foreign currency, what are the forces that that force for the purpose of demand and supply of foreign currency, how many types of foreign exchange markets are there, then what are the functions of foreign exchange market, and who are the participants in the foreign exchange market who are playing the important role for determination of foreign currency or for the determination of different foreign exchange rate for conversion of one currency with the another currency. So keep watching. Thank you.